Hi, welcome to another episode of
Projectile or Not!
So projectile motion means an object is flying through the air and the only thing that it's affecting its flight is gravity. For example, watch this soccer ball. If an object is in projectile motion, we'll see that its horizontal or sideways velocity remains constant throughout its flight, but its vertical velocity changes. Gravity causes it to accelerate towards the ground at 9.8 meters per second squared. That means for every second of flight, its downward velocity will increase by about 10 meters per second. Here we import the video into Logger Pro. We can do an analysis to see how the position of the ball changes during its flight. This graph shows the horizontal position versus time for the soccer ball during its flight. The slope of this graph shows the horizontal velocity, and because the slope remains constant, we can see that the horizontal velocity remains constant. This graph shows the vertical velocity versus time. The slope of this graph shows the vertical acceleration. For the soccer ball, the slope is just what we'd expect, minus 9.8 meters per second squared. We're going to use these ideas of projectile motion to analyze the movie Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon. In the martial arts fighting scenes in this movie, there seem to be two kinds of characters. The stars of the movie seem to be able to float around when they jump. They don't seem to follow the kind of projectile motion that we would normally expect. Whereas the fighters that aren't as good, when they move, they do seem to follow the normal kind of projectile motion that you would expect an object in flight to have. For example, here's Jen. She's the star of the movie. And when she jumps around, her body does not seem to follow a path we would expect a projectile to follow. On the other hand, here's a group of local thugs that try to take Jen on when she's trying to eat a meal at a restaurant. They think they're way better than she is. Let's analyze a scene where one of these guys gets knocked out of a balcony window and lands on the ground, and we'll see what his motion looks like as he falls. We imported that clip into Logger Pro and did a frame-by-frame analysis so that we could see what the vertical motion of the guy looked like as he fell to the ground. Look closely at the graph, you can see that the zero velocity line is at the top of the graph. So the velocity of this guy is becoming increasingly negative. That's just what we'd expect for an object that's falling. In fact, if you look at the slope of the line, you can see that it's around minus 9 meters per second squared. That's very close to the free fall acceleration that a person should have if they're falling. This is Li Mu Bai. He's a good guy in the movie, and he's an amazing fighter. In one scene, he's chasing Jen, and the two of them jump across a pond. Here's a graph of Li Mu Bai's horizontal position versus time. The slope of this graph should show us his horizontal velocity. And so if his horizontal velocity is constant, we should see a constant slope. Since he's moving to the left, the slope is negative. You can see that it's not constant. As he moves farther and farther, his velocity increases. This could be because of the camera angle. As he comes closer to the camera, he appears to be moving faster and faster. Either way, it's pretty close to showing a constant horizontal velocity, which is what we'd expect for a person in midair. Now here's a graph of his vertical velocity versus time. The slope of this graph should show us his vertical acceleration. We'd expect, if he's in free fall, that his vertical acceleration would be 9.8 meters per second squared downward. And he does show a vertical acceleration, but it's minus 2 meters per second downward. so he's not accelerating as quickly as he would if he were in freefall. It seems like the creators of this movie did this on purpose. They made his motion look similar to, but not exactly right, for a projectile. It makes his motion look magical, but at the same time, believable. This movie is filled with scenes like this, where characters move with motion that's not exactly what we've come to expect, but not entirely fake-looking either. It's as though the creators of this movie used our expectation for how objects normally move to help make these characters look believable and yet magical. Well, thanks for joining us for another episode of
Projectile Motion!